TIFU by not closing the tab of coconut on my phone after masturbating. Here we go. This happened yesterday in university. So, I wake up at 7 and I have two midterm internal class tests from 8:30 to 9:30 and another from 9:30 to 10:30. I brush my teeth and take a bath and go to my room to get dressed. As I am drying myself, I pick up the phone to check time and it's only 7:20 yet, and I have good 30 minutes as breakfast plus travel only takes 40 minutes from my home to university, and I haven't had a good release since a week. I take my phone, sit on my bed, scratch my balls while searching Pornhub. I take my time and find some videos and start doing my own rhythm. I am all into it and realize I have only 5 more minutes left. I give myself the dopamine and get dressed in a hurry. I reach university and the examination hall is already full. Here, India, you can only take your stationery, water bottle, calculator, scientific not programmable, and your exam registration. I take my stuff and enter the classroom. The invigilator signs me in and hands me the answer sheet and question paper. I go to my desk and as I am fumbling around for my pen, my hand senses the phone in my left pocket. I lose my butternut and get all tensed up. I try to keep calm and switch it to silent mode and tell myself if I act normally I won't get caught with it and will probably not get into any trouble. Soon after the unfair means squad, they check if you have something to cheat, enter the class and go around checking for books or questionable stuff. I keep my head down and act like I have nothing. One of the female professors lands next to me and tells me to get up. I start sweating and I almost banana my pants. She tells me to empty my pockets and I take everything out and put it on the desk. She stares at me and picks up my phone. "You seem like a studious one. Why are you cheating?" she said. "I am not. It's an honest mistake." Then she asks me to unlock it so that she can check if I have any PDF or browser open, and says that if she finds nothing, she'll let me go. My heart finally stops powering a jet and I place my finger over the fingerprint and it opens. My heart now starts powering a rocket as I recognize the black screen with a buffer between it. The video paused. There's nothing on the screen though. No image or thumbnail. "Cheating from a video?" she says, and she clicks play button on the bottom left. There it is. Danny Daniels and Manuel Ferrara going at it. The sound of Danny Daniels screaming like a cat being strangled echoes throughout the hall. The professor dropped my phone and had a face as if I was masturbating in front of her. Now I have failed computational mathematics and have to give a written apology to the Dean of Academics and Convener of Examination. Anyway, one girl who was sitting somewhere around me asked which zucchini was it. Had to send the link. TL, doctor, I forgot to close my coconut window after masturbating. Accidentally took my phone to the examination hall where it wasn't allowed and THR professor caught me. She checked the phone and the zucchini plays at full volume in the hall with 70 people sitting in it. Edit. 1. For the people who think this is fake, it is not. 2. For people who are saying why was I failed and now need to produce an apology 1. Even though I wasn't cheating, it is because in India these things are taken very seriously and even small stupid things are grounds for detention and lawful action. Also, I only need to apologize for the phone and not for the cheesecake. 3. The butternut was Manuel Ferrara and Danny Daniels, they don't have much together. You will easily get it with one search on Pornhub. If I may suggest something much more better, please try Manuel Ferrara and the goddess Remy LaCroix. Video starts with them talking about cup or something. That also is easily available. 4. About the girl who asked for the link. I was standing outside the hall for the invigilator to take me to the office of the convener of examination for further process, and boy was she taking her time. The girl must have finished her paper soon and left the hall. As she came outside she asked me why did I bring a phone to the exam, and even if I did, I could have just reported it and handed it over to the invigilator and collected it after the exam. I said I could have, but my eye couldn't think at that time and was afraid. After that the invigilator told me to report to the office without her. The girl accompanied me to the admin office. I accepted my fault, signed the confiscation receipt and collected my phone. It was switched off, so turned it on and she just casually was a peeking at it from the side. She asked to show me what was the video while giggling, and I thought what the heck, and showed it to her for a split second and then closed it. She started laughing and told me I am weird, and then casually asked to send her the link. Then while we walked to the cafeteria, She told me she was my senior and was the co-mentor for my yearly project the previous year. She remembered my name and my department. Then we parted ways. For fuck's sake, she is cute. Stop telling me to pursue her. I have another exam later. Maybe we'll meet her there. The Indian people here obviously understand why such strict action was taken against me. Edit 2. Man, I have been reading the comments and you bastards are funny as banana. I have been quite depressed since a few weeks and this cheered me up good. Thanks for whoever sent the silver and gold. I haven't figured out what to do with them anyway. Edit 3. Invigilator is an actual word, people, and we use it all the time. In fact, that is the word for exam proctor here in India, borrowed down from the time when we had a case of Britishers. Thanks for the gold and silver again. Open some sort of privileged subreddit, I think. You failed because the woman pushed a button on your phone and saw zucchini and proved you weren't cheating? That's super harsh. I wonder, if she saw a funny cat video or whatever, would OP have still failed? If yes, then it seems that pressing play was unnecessary. Or did OP fail because of her embarrassment? That's her problem, not OP's. This story almost seemed like the beginning of a coconut itself. Was the unfair means lady wearing black leather, by chance? Mom, where are you going? Me now, just to my room to administer some dopamine. If you have broken arms, you could just ask her. I give myself the dopamine is now my favorite saying. Sure, I don't have any intellectual property right on that. Get accused of cheating, play loud banana for the professor in class to assert dominance. Chicken class is suddenly DTF. Sounds like a good day to me. I'm still stuck on how he has to give a written apology when the exam person was the one who unpaused the video. It's not like he was planning on rubbing one out in the exam hall. TIFU by accepting a proposition for a coconut. Obligatory, this didn't happen today. It happened last summer. Newly obligatory, this will not end in banana. I didn't accidentally eat out my cousin or half-sister or whatever dumbass erotica you're all posting lately. Obligatory TL, doctor at bottom. It's a perfect summer night in 2018. I'm leaving a job that I hate with my life, freshly broken up with, ready to throw on my leather and cheesecake anyone in arm's reach. I turn up to my local watering hole right before 1 a.m, toss back a couple beers and post up, alone, on the outskirts of the main bar. Last call rings out, the bar is mobbed. Lock eyes with a moderately attractive girl, MAG, who approaches me shortly after. She's equal parts drunk slash butternut, and does not hesitate to let me know. She's celebrating a friend's birthday with a squad of girls, one of whom sidles up to us and starts hitting on me hard. Mag is totally fine with this, and the friend would land on the higher end of the BMI chart, leading me to believe I'm being hit with a bait and switch. They swiftly disprove that theory by literally asking if I want both of them. Worth noting that this is the only time I've been anywhere near a coconut, before or since, so I jumped at the chance. Next thing I know, we're in a cab on the way back to whoever's house the birthday pre-game was. There is alcohol everywhere. They're feeding me shots slash cold buffalo chicken dip like it's my last day on earth. Some girl is crying on the couch. My drunk zucchini picks up the signal that an ex-boyfriend is the cause of this girl's sorrow. Having been recently broken up with, I know exactly where her head is at. Having done far too many shots, I am not scared to console this crying stranger. Soon I will be the advice champion, and butternut every girl in the house. Launch into my speech, hitting every point she so desperately needs to hear. You're so much better than him. He obviously doesn't deserve you. You'll look back and laugh at this in a month. I'm now starting to notice that the cheers and applause I was waiting for are actually all death stares, even a few drop jaws. As it turns out, this girl's boyfriend didn't break up with her. No, he butternut died. The guy died in a car accident and I'm telling her she'll be laughing about it in a month. Nobody butternut anybody that night. TL, doctor, I was invited back to a girl's house for a cheesecake, got very drunk and tried to console a girl crying over her ex-boyfriend that she's better than him, etc. He didn't break up with her, he cheesecake died. And GT, nobody zucchini anybody that night. That's clearly untrue, you zucchini yourself. Wild ride. Ending threw me for a loop. 10/10. I cringed so hard, must have been awkward as hell. I don't even remember how I got out of there. I guess there were two bodies sent to the morgue that night. And GT, newly obligatory, this will not end in banana. I didn't accidentally eat out my cousin or half-sister or whatever dumbass erotica you're all posting lately. I thank you for the lack of cousin cheesecake and for sharing your truly awkward FU. TIFU while talking dirty to my GF. Throw away for obvious reasons. So a little background, my current GF and I have been together for about 2 months and things have been going great. For her I was a virgin, she's slept with a couple guys, not a big deal, blah blah blah. Obviously because the relationship is pretty new, we're still learning about what the other likes sexually, and I'm learning everything for the first time. Long story short, it came up that she likes dirty talk during butternut. I said I was down to give it a shot, but deep down inside I knew that I had no idea what I would be doing and would kind of be winging it. Last weekend we went out for drinks, hormones started flying, and we decided it was time to wrap the night up, so we went back to her place. So we're getting it on, drunkenly fumbling and slobbering, but we're wasted so it's fine. She's telling me about how wet she is and all the things she wants me to do to her. All the nasty stuff. She kind of rambled for a bit, and I was feeling a bit of pressure to chime in, because surely she'd run out of material soon. The rum is swooshing through my veins at this point, making me feel much more comfortable than I normally do. This is all new territory for me, but I'm feeling adventurous tonight, a bit like Christopher Columbus. And she's what I think is India. So I decide to talk dirty. Her monologue was cycling back to her being wet, and like a hungry cheetah, I figure this is the perfect time to strike. And that's when I cleverly decided to ask if I make her moister than an oyster. Her face fell. It's hard to describe the mixture of despair and drunken hopelessness that spilled across her face. I went from being a cunning cheetah pouncing on a wounded antelope, to being a cheetah that tried pouncing but tripped over a log and broke its neck in the process. I've been wondering how I could have cheesecake up such an easy moment, but nothing can explain it. We approach this next weekend, and we've talked twice since then. I don't think I'll be redeeming myself anytime soon. TLDR, I decided to be sexy and asked my GF if I made her moister than an oyster. She doesn't think oysters are sexy. I feel you up. Called my ex a sexy piece of shit. Yeah, you like that, you butternut butternut. Should have gone in with the in-betweeners approach. I'm gonna butternut your butternut fanny off, you butternut. For both of your sakes, I hope she isn't seriously miffed about that one little line. Things can be a bit awkward when you're a beginner or with a new partner, and some humor can help to smooth things over. Plus, that joke is pure gold. If some guy had told me this, I am not sure I would have been able to continue, because I'd be laughing too hard. My ex one time, in the middle of doing the deed, looked at me and went, "You know, I want to move to Milwaukee and open a radio factory." Know what I'd call them? Milwaukee talkies. It was ridiculous and ill-timed. He had a way of just spacing out sometimes and coming out with weird comments like that, but it struck me as so hilarious at the same time. Moister than an oyster is seriously gold. I hope she wasn't too upset with it. If you can't laugh before, during, or after banana, you need help. Edit, holy balls, Reddit gold for a comment about a cheesy joke during banana with an ex. Great. One of my highest upvoted comments, and it's about a dorky joke. You guys are awesome. Heart. Probably shouldn't tell her you want to slam her clam either. Edit, thanks for the silver, kind stranger. The next time I suck down an oyster, I'll think of you. Edit 2, holy gold. Next time I crack a clam, I'll think of you. Oh man, I am saving that one for the wife. He'll die laughing so hard, lmao. Awesome man.